What's up, everyone? Today, Chef Daddy Lau is going to teach us all about how to use a Chinese chef knife, how to sharpen a knife, and how you can thinly slice meat even if you don't have one of these knives. This is the second video of our three-part hot pot series, centered around teaching you how to prepare for a hot pot celebration at home. In the first video, my parents took us on a grocery run, showing us how they shop for the highest quality meats while saving money. In the third video, you'll get our recipes for homemade fish balls, sauces, our simple soup base, and I'll also be sharing some options for the equipment you'll need. Check out our description for links to our hot pot playlist and other videos in this series, as well as our blog post on madewithlao.com for our full shopping list and instructions on how to prepare a hot pot meal. Let's dive into the second part of this series on basic knife skills.
各位朋友，我哋又见面啦。咁我哋今日咧就准备整诶打边炉。咁国语讲咧就火锅，我哋广东人讲惯都就话打边炉啦。咁咧，我哋准备咗啲肉啊、牛肉嗰箩箩啲嘢喺度，准备一阵点样切嗰啲肉俾佢大家睇下。个切之前咧，我就回应一下上次有一个朋友，佢话点样切磨嗰把刀，点样处理把刀。嗱，我而家就话俾你听，刀咧，我把刀咧就系用咗已经差唔多40年噶啦，好耐噶啦。
As my dad mentioned, his knife is older than I am, which speaks to how well my dad takes care of his stuff, as well as the durability of the knife. It's a traditional stainless steel knife made by Dexter Russell, an American brand which was and still is a popular favorite amongst Chinese-American chefs, dating back to the 1800s when the first Chinese immigrants started arriving. Even though it's sometimes called a Chinese cleaver, this type of knife is much thinner than other cleavers that are designed to hack through bones or thick meats. In Cantonese, it's called a choi to, which literally means vegetable knife if you split up the characters. A Chinese chef knife is versatile enough to julienne vegetables or joint the chicken. You'll also often see my dad use the blade to scoop and move chopped ingredients around, or as a blunt surface to crush garlic or create purees. This is the only knife my dad uses, replacing an entire set of kitchen knives. There are a lot of great Chinese chef knives out there, but if you're interested in getting the exact knife my dad uses, I've included a link in our description.
磨刀呢，首先要分你左手用刀同你右手用刀。如果你右手用刀嘅话呢，你就呢边呢要斜嘅，个口要斜嘅，呢边呢就比较平啲嘅。嗱，反转嚟讲呢，如果你用左手切刀切嘢嘅话呢，你就呢边呢要斜啲，呢边呢就要平啲，咁样分开。嗱，我系用右手嘅，嗱，所以呢，我磨刀嘅时候呢，就呢边呢要斜啲，即系。 首先落啲水落去先，个磨刀个石头壳，嗱斜斜地啦，嗱，翻覆，大力揿住佢，快啲啊！咁跟住咧，就呢边要平啲噶啦，平系点啫？头先就咁样斜斜地啊，系咪？而家我就摆平啲佢，磨刀嘅方法就系咁样啦。刀咧，只不过系攞个刀锋，睇知唔知把刀嚟唔嚟咧，锋唔锋利咧？ 你攞咗手指夹丝就知啦。嗱，如果你揩落佢个手指夹度，将刀揩到个手指夹唔喐啦，咁就把刀咧就影熟啦。嗱，如果你把刀系唔锋利嘅，佢会跣咗落个下边嘅，咁嗰把刀咧已经就够利啦吓。睇到嗱，呢边都系啫嘛。如果你左手用刀嘅，右刀系一样，斜嘅向出，平嘅向入边，咁样啊，揸刀啦，系咪？咁呢把刀咧就切得嚟咧，佢嚿肉咧，佢就会食字咁落噶啦。 系嘛，明白未啊？就系咁啦，仲有一样话俾你听，撬门切切下把刀唔利就点咧？唔一定要把刀食，个个屋企有个碟系咪？呢边咧唔系滑噶，鞋嘅。咁你如果把刀仲要喺咁样就咁样磨刀，快啲攞个刀锋嗱，呢边咧向呢边斜斜地，呢边平嘅嘛，呢边斜啲嗱，睇下睇下嘛。 睇到嗱，就咁样切攞个刀，攞个碟就得啦。嗰把刀就会好利好多噶啦。嗱，睇到嘛？嗯，就系咁简单，知道嘛？我凭我自己咁多年切嘢嘅经验咧，我就咁样攞个刀锋啦。唔系一定系咁样，个个唔系一定系咁样。我自己嘅经验就系咁样。
Just to add a few more notes, it's counterintuitive, but a sharper knife actually causes fewer injuries. Simply due to the law of averages, a sharper knife leads to fewer cuts, which lowers the chance of injury. The block my dad is using to sharpen his knife is called a sharpening stone or a whetstone, or 磨刀石 in Cantonese. Most brands label their whetstones with one or more grit numbers, which mostly refers to the size of the abrasive particles in the stone. The higher the grit number, the smoother and sharper the finish of the knife. The lower the grit number, the quicker the knife's material gets removed. If your knife is dull or even damaged, generally you start sharpening your knife with a lower grit rating, and then you'd use a stone with a higher grit rating to get a more razor sharp edge. If you're interested in getting a sharpening stone for yourself, we've also included links to a few great options for sharpening stones in our description. There's way more to be said about selecting whetstones and how to use them, so if you're curious, I highly recommend checking out Perfection, a fellow YouTube creator that has a ton of great content on everything you need to know about knives and properly caring for them.
好, 刀就處理好了, 我們現在開始切東西了, 首先, 切牛肉先, 在 Costco, 6.99元一磅, 很漂亮的牛肉, 買回來是軟的嘛, 軟的, 在水洗過之後呢, 就放入Freezer, 放入Freezer, 雪硬了, 譬如放在這邊的桌子, 讓它慢慢解凍了一半左右, 不要讓它完全解凍, 切才容易, 如果完全硬的呢, 又切不到了, 完全軟的又難切了, 所以我就半軟半硬地切, 因為我要切得很薄地打邊爐的嘛。
Just to add some more notes on getting your meat partially thawed, let's say you have meat that's 100% frozen and you wanted to prepare a hot pot on a Saturday. On Friday night, you'd move the meat out of the freezer and into the refrigerator overnight. In the morning, the meat should be partially thawed. If you were starting with fresh meat, then you'd place it in the freezer for about 1 to 2 hours. With both of these methods, the amount of time you freeze and thaw depends on your refrigerator and the thickness of your meat, but this is a good starting point. The meat should still be hard, but it should have some give. You'll know if it's still too frozen if you have a really hard time cutting it, in which case you can let it thaw for another hour or two. If the meat moves around when you try to cut it, then it's too thawed, in which case you can freeze it again for another 30 minutes.
Yeah, 首先呢,我們將肥的去掉它先。 切東西呢,一定要鑑自己牛肉。 還有呢,唔記得話俾你聽,因為毛巾擺下邊,咁樣呢,佢斬板呢,佢就唔會斜喐嚟咗去嘅,睇到嗎?睇到嗎?切出嚟嘅牛肉就係咁一片好薄㗎啦,睇到嗎?一片片,排好佢,直情咁樣一片片排好佢,睇到?或者你想呢邊嚟又得,調整嘅又得,就唔使顧,睇隻手啦。
For me, I don't have any cutting skill, but Daddy Lau, he built this excellent cutting skill from all those years, like so many immigrants, hardworking, thousands of immigrants in the country. They work very hard. Average, he cut at least 40, 50 pounds meat when he's working, almost every day. His hands, just like a manual machine, keep moving, keep cutting. A lot of time, because when you cut meat, right, you need to be very, very sharp knife. If the knife not sharp, you cannot do the job. No matter how he careful, he's still cutting his finger. Sometimes cut big, sometimes cut small. When I see the bleeding from the cutting finger, I feel painful. But for him, he just put the gauze on, put the band-aid on, wrap the wound, then continue to walk. Because this is for his children, for his family, and for his loyalty customer for his restaurant.
我們切到一碟了,全片擺放正,擺放正這裡。肉呢,就切到這裡這麼多先了,給大家看一下,方法就是這樣。我們還有其他東西,很多肉要切。我們切那些破叉,已經洗乾淨了,即是衛生一點,自己洗過的嘛,是不是?要不要沖水?沖一沖水? 首先先弄皮,破叉也一樣。 都是放在Freezer拿出來,等它一半解凍,才能切得到。因為我們用來切薄的,除非你不切的,你又在Market買的,切好了的,這樣就行。但是你又貴很多。切這些,直接切下去。切的東西,手指一定要壓住牛肉,讓它不要四處走。用大力的手指壓住牛肉。
When you look at him, he looks so easy. He looks so easy to cut. He takes many years to practice. For now, you can buy a lot of cut meat in the market, but sometimes you still need to cut at home. I encourage our fans, if you're interested, just take a tie. Your mind, your eye, your left hand, your right hand, both have to cooperate in the same time. Because if you don't, then very easy to get injury. We don't want that happen. Slowly, you will improve your cutting skill. You will put the knife cutting meat for your hot pot meal for your family. Have a fun. Have a fun. Have a relax time.
切到手尾嗰啲薄嘅時候咧，你壓都唔壓壓壓唔到嘅咧，就咁切啦。用手指公壓住嚿肉。嚟，切細啦，睇到啊？我哋切好之後咧，又係俾個碟排好佢，撲叉切好，然後而家就切雞胸肉先，都係一樣，要擺 freezer 攞出嚟半硬咁樣切。
如果你冇呢個把刀咧，
用其他刀得嘅，咪慢慢切咯。啊，啲西人刀嗰啲窄嗰啲刀啊，好多人窄嘅刀，你咪一樣得啫嘛，你咪個方法唔同，慢慢切咯，係嘛？嗱，好薄。打邊爐嘅時候咧，一嚟一淋水就得噶啦，啊一片片係好薄，係咪？片片好薄。嚟，我哋用油，我哋做其他嘢先嚇，先做呢、這個係魷魚，魷魚咧成條就咁，我喺中間俾刀整開佢，搣佢出嚟嚇。嗱喺個中間俾個刀劏開佢。啲腸搣曬出嚟，搣乾淨佢。就咁樣嗱，睇到嘛？搣咗，搣上嗱，俾水度睇住佢。呢啲咧就攞翻個魚鬚嗱，我哋喺眼睛下邊嘅咧就唔好要噶啦，眼睛下邊嘅唔好要啦。咦？呢啲好食啊！就係咁樣嗱，睇到嘛？啲眼睛以下嘅唔要。鱿鱼就系咁处理法啦，嗱，过一过水啦，干净啲啦，系咪？嗱，我得啦，唔好干净啊，搣咗皮唔好干净啊。切鱿鱼咧，我接俾大家睇下先啦，唔系成块食噶嘛，系咪？仲要点嘅啫？跟住个肚入边嗰度，唔系个鱼仔个出边嗰度，呢度系出边，呢度系个肚入边嗰度，吓，唔系有呢冇鱼仔嗰边咁样切，睇住轻轻咁计得噶啦，轻轻咁整几，唔好整断佢，系咁得啦。嗱，轻轻，先之后咧，三角。三角即係意思卷咗上嚟，佢會卷埋，佢會卷咗卷埋啊，係咪？你要切開中間嗰啲，佢先至卷得埋噶嘛，折埋佢好似個好似個喇叭咁樣整啊，係咪？啊，知道嘛？嗱嗱，三角一熟咗佢咪卷埋咯。如果你唔切嘅嘛，唔卷埋咯。如果你唔切嘅咪卷得嚟唔係咁靚嘅咯，係嘛？咁卷佢卷起嚟就好靚啦嘛，係嘛？嗱，呢啲咪三角嘅咯，總之個三角佢卷佢要咁啦，係嘛？明白嗎？嗱，我哋有首先切好之後咧，要醃一醃佢。
To marinate the squid, all we need to do is add half a teaspoon of baking soda and half a teaspoon of water to an empty bowl. Then we'll add our squid and mix it around the bowl.
魷魚因為佢係硬啲，俾啲啲冰水落佢之後咧，佢啲肉咧就唔會咪爽啲、脆啲，係嘛？撈勻佢就係咁樣撈勻佢，將佢俾啲 baking soda 整到佢啲冇咁硬。好啦，整好啦，我哋擺個雪櫃啊，得就擺雪櫃。仲有一樣咧，我今日就想整多樣，生日就整多羹啊，整多啲嘢俾你食啦，係咪？我就整啲魚片啊，整魚片咧就幫你睇到佢個紋喺度，一條條啊嘛。嗱、啊，咁整多啲俾你食啊，嗱，咁咪生日啊嘛。
Just to add a quick note, the fish does not need to be frozen beforehand, since we're not cutting it nearly as thin as our other meats. Next, we'll be marinating our fish with some flavor. We'll be using a quarter teaspoon of salt, some white pepper to taste, a quarter teaspoon of chicken bouillon, 1 teaspoon of cornstarch, and 2 tablespoons of water. We'll mix our fish pieces around for about 20 seconds to evenly distribute the flavor.
等緊就咁不留佢落一落就食得噶啦，嚇！今日你生日，整多啲嘢俾你食，嚇！好，咁多嘢啦。
That concludes part 2 of our 3-part series on hot pot. Check out our description for links to our blog post and the other videos in the series. If you like this video and want to see more from us, be sure to subscribe, like this video, and comment below with what other content you'd like to see from us next. On behalf of the Lau family, thank you so much for watching.
Say hi, Auntie.
Hi.
Hi.
Happy
birthday!
Happy birthday to me!
Happy birthday!